Dear friends, we're coming to the closing. I will ask Theo Xenakoudis from the Marshall Islands, the International Registry, to provide closing remarks. And I would like to thank him for sponsoring the cocktails, which we are about to enjoy very shortly. So Theo, thank you, and the floor is yours.
Thank you, Nicholas. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be quite short because I understand everybody wants to looking forward to ending the day. So it's my honor to provide the closing remarks for what has been a very insightful and engaging day of presentations, discussions, and debates. I must start by thanking all the speakers today for sharing their expertise and opinions on the key issues surrounding regulations, decarbonization, digitization, finance, and many other critical factors that will shape our businesses in the coming years. I would like also to say congratulations to Mr. George Papabiou for the Capital Link Greek Shipping Leadership Award, which is a very well-deserved award. Now, I'm sure you will all agree that there are a number of big challenges on the horizon, for many of which we don't even have the answer yet. 6 months ago, nobody would be able to predict or plan for the effects of a pandemic, but the outbreak of the coronavirus is an example of how rapidly challenges present themselves in our industry. The potential ramifications of this virus outbreak on our sector are significant and widespread. The combined effects of falling freight rates, potential new legislation that will come into effect, and the supply chain slowdown are all critical businesses for many of us. However, I would like to urge all of you to remember those that are at the center of this crisis, our people. Our crews rely on us, and we owe them a duty of care to do our utmost to support and protect them during this difficult period. It is also important to stress that, of course, there are opportunities. That much was clear from the many panels and debates that we had today. From a flag state perspective, we should be very well resourced in order to develop a suitable regulatory framework and mechanism in order to enforce these changes. For the many new environmental and fuel-related issues, there is much work to be done to ensure that the highest standards of safety, security, and sustainability, both environmental and economic, are maintained or even improved. And this requires rules and regulations to standardize operations and ensure a level playing field. On the other side, we know that the regulatory framework governing the maritime finance industries are quite complex, extremely detailed, and many times contentious. Quite new standards are the new trends of today, like Poseidon principles or ESG, and of course, international sanctions. And that is why it's quite reassuring, actually, today to see so many people from all over the world, and especially the Greek market, from our industry, that share their expertise in raising difficult questions and topics. Different ways of financing are still discussed, which is very positive today, from banking to leasing houses and steel capital markets. On our side, from a registry point of view, we have to commit significant resources to help the industry to understand and adjust to the fast-changing regulatory environment. We do all that we can to inform to the new developments and the new regulations. We have an expertise representation in the IMO, and we have to maintain open communications with the shipping community. Our people are, of course, can be found in London in the IMO, but also throughout the major shipping centers, providing close support to the fleet. What is also clear from today's discussion is that our willingness as an industry to explore and debate issues in events like Capital Link will help us also to deliver solutions that will take the maritime sector forward for many more generations to come. Now, as Mr. Prokopiou said, let's enjoy our hobby, because this is a hobby. I would like to say special thanks to Olga and Nicholas for what they're doing and keep up with these successful events. And now you're all welcome to join us for some drinks and enjoy the cocktails. Thank you very much.